Welcome to another edition of the Insider Mailbag. I'm Jared Johnson. I'm joined by the mighty Joe Yeager. We're kind of huddled here, basically hiding from the wind. It's coldy. It's coldy? Well, it's windy and it's cold, so it's coldy. Yeah, I just made that up. No, but it's, you know, last week it was sun shining and, you know, we were feeling good. Now we're huddled, you know, under one of these, in one of these tunnels, basically.
Yeah, there's the approaching storm, blizzard of the century is rolling in, as they tend to do once every year, the blizzard of the century. So, right now it hadn't started up just yet, but it is mighty, mighty cold.
Good news is I get to break out my Zamboni to go through the streets. I don't know if you knew I had that in the garage, parked in the garage, a Zamboni. It's a mini Zamboni, but
I thought that was like some sort of a sausage, an Italian sausage or something like that. What the heck is a Zamboni?
Not a hockey fan, I see.
I guess not.
All right, moving on. We have some great questions from y'all. All right, the first question comes from Tech Freak, who wants to know, will Texas Tech get to 6 wins in football next year? So what do you think, Joe? You think the Red Raiders will get to bowl eligibility next season?
Yeah, I'm cautiously optimistic. You know, I mean, I don't think that they're going to just completely drop off the earth with this coaching transition. I mean, I have some confidence in this coaching staff. I think it's an upgrade over the previous coaching staff. I really do. Yeah. We haven't seen anything yet from them, but that's on the field, obviously. But I do believe that they're going to stabilize this program pretty quickly, and that you probably are looking at about a 500 year next year. And, you know, I think we'll probably see some signs that are all going to probably make us fairly confident going into the year after that.
Yeah, I mean, for me, it's hard for me to say until I at least see them in practice. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I know we're talking about practice here, but still, I mean, I haven't seen how they're going to utilize this roster and everything, but the Red Raiders do return a lot. You got to feel better about the quarterback position going into spring ball this year than you did last year, that's for sure. I mean, even if you, let's just say, honestly, any of the 3 quarterbacks, I feel like you can win some of the games on your schedule with. Right. McLean, he showed enough against Baylor that if he's healthy, that he can do it. And then Jet, for all his faults, also showed, you know, he could do some things. And then, of course, Alan Bowman, I mean, he was leading the country in passing before his lung deflated. So if he's healthy, then, you know, I feel like you have a really good shot there. And that's honestly a big part of the battle. You return a lot of your offensive line. You're going to have some, you know, Tazon, Sirajic. You're going to have some running back talent there. On defense, you lose your safeties, and that's troubling. But then again, your secondary was terrible. So maybe, you know, some change there could be good, too, to be honest. So, yeah, I mean, look, Rico's on board. You saw him tweet. You know, that's a big part of your defense. Rico's a very talented player. I mean, if Jordan Brooks returns, that's another guy. I mean, hey, you have those 2 linebackers, guys like Broderick up front for you. You're feeling pretty good that you can win 6 or 7 games, I feel. I felt like they could have this year, to be honest.
Yeah, should have.
AA Cuff 22 wants to know, basically, if Tech has any chance to flip any of the decommits that occurred. You know, basically since Matt Wells and his staff was hired, has taken over the program. And there have been, I believe, 5 that have been announced. I think there's a couple, actually, that, honestly, the coaching staff may not be big on, you know, to be honest. But I talked, Zach Tanner and I both talked to a bunch of the recruits. I mean, I've talked with over 20 recruits in the last 48 hours, including Stephen Parker, who decommitted. He was your longest commit. He was your highest rated commit, 4-star defensive end. And bottom line is, he has not shut out Texas Tech. By the time you see this, the coaches would have already visited him at his school at South Oak Cliff. He also told me that it is a possibility that he might take an official visit the following weekend, which would be, and I already messed this up on the board once, but the weekend of December 15th, I believe. So you have a shot there. And he has family. His grandma still lives out here in Lubbock. He lived half of his life, or actually the majority of his life, he's lived out here. He likes Lubbock. You have a really good shot there, I believe, in getting him back. I'm not saying you will, but you have a shot there. Another guy I talked with Wednesday night, Keon Stewart. He's a guy who's, I think, is vastly underrated. Whether he ends up at TCU, Houston, Tech, Washington, whatever, wherever he ends up, he's a better player than he's rated. He's on one of the best high school defenses in the entire country. And they're still rolling in the playoffs at Galena Park North Shore. And he's a really fast DB. He can play corner, he can play safety. I like Keon Stewart a lot. He told me he was visited by Coach Wells and Coach Juice Brown, who he's become my favorite just by his nickname. You know, we are about the nicknames, Money Joe. But no, he was really impressed. He was kind of, you could tell, I mean, obviously he decommitted, but he was kind of down on the whole coaching change. But after the coaches visited, he told me he feels a lot better. He understands. He told me what they're about and the plan they have for turning the program around, and he was impressed. So I asked him, hey, did you recommit to Texas Tech? And he said, nah, not yet. So not yet sounds pretty dang good to me. That means he's at least highly considering getting back on board. He also said he's going to wait till February, so they're going to have to keep recruiting him, Monty Joe. But that you know, hey, that's a guy that you might be able to get back on board. Those two just alone, we have more on the board, but just with those two alone, you get both those guys back on your commit list, you're feeling pretty dang good. And I think there's some opportunities to augment some of the guys that this coaching staff want, who are already committed, with some guys that they were on when they were at Utah State, who I think could help round out this class and be a fairly good bridge class, to be honest. All right, DoorJack TT05 wants to know, now that we know a little bit more about Coach Wells and his coordinators, what is our biggest concern or question mark about next season, and then what are we most excited about? What do you think, Joe? Let's start off with our biggest question mark each.
Yeah, I mean, just the overall defense, because, I mean, it's been a problem here for about as long as anybody can remember. After last season, you know, it looked like David Gibbs might have had the corner turn.
Things had changed.
Yes, things have changed, and maybe a little bit, somewhat, in the early to mid portion of the season, you still had some hope. But then later in the season, just the same old stuff. They were bad again. You know, they really, really were. They really were. And you return some people on defense, but you lose Dakota Allen, for instance, and the safeties and everything like that. Boy, the secondary was just awful. So, I mean, Keith Patterson and those guys on defense, they got their work cut out for them. I mean, they've got some pieces to work with, but they're obviously going to be installing their own scheme and system. Combine that with the fact that of the historical problems that Texas had on defense and late last year as well, and that defense has to be considered a real question mark going in. And so, you know, that's kind of obvious, but yeah, that's my major concern.
Yeah, that's my top concern too. So I'll just stick with that. I think I'm going to assume, and correct me if I'm wrong, that you're going to agree with me on this, but what I'm excited about would be the idea of a real running game and a physical running game, which is what Wells said in his introductory press conference. And then not just saying that, but actually having a plan that they've proven that they've utilized before that's worked and that they're bringing to Texas Tech. And part of that is by using a tight end. And the way David Yost, the offensive coordinator, mentioned the way he would use a tight end. It's got to be a legit dude. They got to, you know, and you can tell they're already recruiting, trying to go after and find that guy or those guys. But the way they're going to use their 11 personnel and move a tight end around formation to get advantageous numbers, I'm excited about. And the fact they said, we're not going to let the defense dictate to us when we run the ball. And then I also like, and you and I mentioned it in a football video or after the press conference, that they, as far as with the hurry up, I know a lot of people are concerned about the, you know, oh no, NASCAR again. It doesn't sound like it's going to be like that type of hurry up. I loved how David Yost said they're going to have like six plays that they really like, and that's what they're going to have to go fast with. And they're going to run it over and over and over and make defenses stop them. That, to me, I really like. He also said he's not going to force the hurry up. If they're not good at it, they're going to scale it back. I mean, it sounds like the things, in my experience and in my humble opinion, that I've always liked to hear coming from coaches' mouths.
Yeah, it sounds like a very common sense approach, you know, which is refreshing. You know, so yeah, I think that's all good stuff. And you know, to me, the what I'm just most excited about is just that there's a change, you know, and I had been despairing, to put it to
if you think he's been negative on the camera and on the record, you should see him off camera.
Yeah, I know. I've been at Alcoholics Anonymous and various support groups and so forth, wondering if the change was actually going to happen, and it did.
Yes.
So I got what I was asking for, what I was hoping for. And so I'm just, you know, really excited to see how it's all going to transpire. And, you know, I can go into next season with some genuine curiosity and excitement and enthusiasm.
Yeah, and to be clear, it was we do. I'm not going to pretend like we don't care about Red Raider football and Red Raider sports, because we do. And I mean, and you probably more so than me, but to it's not to say that, oh, we hated the previous staff, but it was torture because it was obvious that it wasn't going to work out to us for years. So to cover it day in and day out, it's not that we're trying to say, oh, those guys are horrible, but they're obviously ineffective, and it was torture to kind of see it play out like the slow bleed day after day. All right. OkieRaider01 wants to know, how difficult does a totally new staff make your job? He says he's thinking mostly in terms of those sources you had in the old staff, and assumes not all, most of them are gone now. Yeah, I mean, I think we're already seeing that just kind of with some of the recruiting, just because we haven't really had the opportunity to establish relationships with the new coaching staff, you know, other than just the big presser. So, yeah, I mean, that's definitely a thing, and that's part of it. But at the same time, it would have been difficult, we just talked about, to watch the slow bleed, and even just for for Kingsbury and those coaches to see it happen again and see all the effects, what's happened at the Jones where people are leaving. But I mean, in some cases it was before halftime we were seeing it empty out. I mean, so for me, this needed to happen. It had to happen. It's just time for me to do my job. I have no problem, and I put it in air quotes, my job, because I'm like a big kid here getting to talk about sports, you know, all the time. So we'll establish relationships. And it's not just with the coaches too, though. It's with a lot of the other staff that we had sources with, that's the kind of guys behind the scenes that are no longer there. So, I mean, it is a challenge, but it's one that we welcome, is the best way I could say it. I'm excited to see some of those new relationships that we forge and that we bond with all the new faces over there at the football facility. All right, Texas Tech Austin wants to know, what do we feel is a reasonable time frame for the coaching staff to have a team that can compete for a conference championship? I think this is a tremendous question, actually. I think this is the question. What do you think, Joe?
You know, year three. Yeah. Year three. I mean, year one, you get a little bit of a mulligan for obvious reasons. Yeah. A lot of adjustment, new faces, people trying to get everything to mesh together.
Sure.
Year two, you expect to see a little bit of progress.
Right.
You know, you're getting more of your own guys in there. The system's entrenched a little bit in that second year. People should know what they're doing a little bit more.
Right.
So improvement the second year. That third year is when I expect to see a major leap.
Yes.
Where, I mean, not saying a Big 12 title, but at least you're in the conversation and people are saying these guys are contenders. So year three is what I'm looking at.
Yeah, I think by year three, and definitely by year four, you should be at least to what Matt Campbell's been doing at Iowa State, where you're winning significant games. I mean, you upset Oklahoma, beat TCU when they were a top 10 team a couple years ago. This year, you know, follow that up with a strong, eight or nine win season. I mean, that's what I expect year three or year four. This first year, I just want to see how they operate. You know what I mean? Obviously, if they only win three or four games, that's going to be a huge red flag. But assuming that doesn't happen, then I want to see how they operate. I want to see how the players respond. I want to see how they recruit. And honestly, that's going to take at least a year or two to where you could feel okay, I have a handle for how these guys operate. By then, you have enough data from all around, how they treat the staff, how they treat the support staff, how they develop players, recruiting, all that. Their in-game decisions. Then you have enough data after a couple years where you're like, okay. And then ultimately they have to win. This program has to win. That's all that's going to matter, bottom line, because it's been a while since it has one. All right, Mighty Joe, that's going to do it for this edition. Great stuff from you as always. Great questions from y'all. And until next time.